Well, good morning, Emmanuel. Welcome to church this morning. Some of us are gathered online, and of course, some of us are here in the sanctuary. But wherever we find ourselves, I thank all of you for gathering so that we may share in this time together. St. Paul said in his letter to the Corinthians that followers of the way of love become one body with many parts, and so it is with us today. Followers of the way of love becoming one gathering, although in many places. For anyone who may be new to the Emmanuel community or visiting for the first time, we are so glad that you are here and hope that you will join us in some time of fellowship after the service. So you'll remember that pre-COVID, we used to offer our announcements at the beginning of the service. And so we decided that it might be good to start that up again, largely because it gives the online community as well as the in-person community the same opportunity to hear the announcements. So we're slowly gonna start doing that again. So as you feel you want to make an announcement, we're going to start to do that again at the beginning of the service. So I have an announcement today, so I'll start, and then I'll invite for anyone else that has any announcements. So on Friday night, you'll know, some of you will remember Rachel and Janine. They are a new couple who have been new to the Emmanuel community. Anyway, I had the privilege and honor of officiating their marriage here in the sanctuary of Emmanuel on Friday night. So we have a picture. There we are. There's Rachel and Janine. Yeah, it was really beautiful. It was an evening service. We had everything by candlelight, it was very beautiful. So there we go. There's Rachel and Janine. They are off on their honeymoon now, and it'll be lovely to welcome them back in a week or so. Does anybody else have an announcement they'd like to come forward and share at this time? Yes, Christine. That's okay. I'll come to you.
Thanks. I just wanted to ask the congregation, I'm going to be starting a craft group at Ray of Hope, and I'm looking for art supplies, and especially knitting needles and yarn. And hopefully at some point I'll be doing it here at Emmanuel as well. So if you have any lying around or you know anybody, just bring them to the office. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thanks. Yeah.
Thanks, Christine. All right. Any announcements this morning, Neil, before we get started? Okay. Then let us be together in prayer. Oh, Jennifer, yes?
I just wanted to know that on Tuesday, Mason and Sir will do their final oath and become Canadian citizens.
Wonderful. That's a refugee sponsored. How many years ago has that been now? A few years. Wonderful. Great news. Please send them all our best wishes.
Jen, how about the folks online?
Sorry, Stephen. So for the people who are online, you'll raise your hand and Stephen will open your mic. So you won't be, we won't see you, but we will hear you.
So if anybody online has an announcement, please hit the hand button, which is right down on your control panel, and I'll see your hand and I'll allow you to speak. We'll wait a moment here.
Okay. Yeah, forgive us as we implement some of these new things back into our service. So in a new way with the online community and being in person. So there will be bugs to work out.
And Melissa in the chat here, Melissa is asking for prayers for her co-worker who's in hospital waiting for surgery for pancreatitis. So we'll keep Melissa's co-worker in mind.
Yes, Melissa's co-worker.
Well, I'm not seeing any more, Jen. I'll pass it back to you.
All right. Thanks, Stephen. I see Neil coming up here now.
So I could feel Pat's eyes burying in the back of my head. Because on Wednesday, the board, as you may recall, last Sunday, I told you about some of the challenges the church is having. And so last Wednesday, the board met, and Pat led us through a very fruitful discussion of all the things that we can do from now until forever to find a path forward. And so from time to time, I guess me or somebody else will be popping up here to share some things. So I'm not going to tell you everything here because then you'd all fall asleep and you'd miss Jen's sermon, and that would be disappointing. So so I'm just trying to read my notes. I did not plan what I was going to say specifically. The biggest things are, number one, we are exploring doing the Christmas dinner again. I know it's not even yet Halloween, and here I am talking about Christmas dinner, but you have to plan these things further ahead. We haven't figured out yet who's organizing it. We do know that Karen Dixon is the one that has the list of all the things to be done. So if she comes to you and says, would you like to organize the dinner, please don't run away right away. But at the very least, see if there's something on the list you can offer to do. We haven't figured out what the format's going to be, or for that matter, what the date is going to be, but it'll be sometime between now and Christmas, likely on a Saturday. That's as far as we've thought. You may have also seen in the announcement reel running on ahead of the service, we've got the cookie sale and the sock toss, both on the 27th of November. If you're bringing cookies to sell and socks to throw, please don't mix them up. That will be a very difficult kind of toss.
Although if you throw a cookie at me, I will eat it.
I think that's a challenge. You could also bring sock-shaped cookies. Yeah, they're called stockings. Either way you go. So that, then there's two other giving opportunities coming up in November. Again, we're still figuring out some logistics. Number one, some of you may be familiar, or you've done this a few years now, is called Giving Tuesday. It follows Black Friday and Cyber Monday. And Giving Tuesday is, if you have any money left, please keep us in mind as some place to give. It's, again, it's across Canada, giving opportunity, more to follow on that one. And number two, we've been trying to figure out how to bring the offering plates back. We've kind of gotten to the point of, yes, it'd be a good idea, haven't figured out logistics, specifically who is going to hold the plate, pass it around, and then count the money. So if you want to do any of that, let me know. Otherwise, that's it for now. More for me to follow in the weeks to come. Oh, and then of course, yes, haven't talked about Christmas enough. There are four designated offerings we do throughout the year. And the last one, so there's Easter offering, which happens March or April. There's the anniversary offering, which happens in June. There's a Thanksgiving offering that happens at Thanksgiving, and the Christmas offering that happens at Christmas time. And that's an opportunity to make an additional donation to the church in honor of those four particular dates in the year. So that's it. I must say it's also been a bit disconcerting. I don't know how Jen does this, but as I'm talking to you, there I am down there as well. Every time I glance over there to see me, and I realize I'm not looking at the camera, and it's just completely weird. So that's it for me.
Thanks, Neil. You gave away my secret. I'm not really looking at everybody out there. I'm looking at me. Just kidding. Let us be together in prayer. Let's pray. Loving God, we, your saints, gather to worship and praise you this day. We celebrate the saints who have served you and been an example for us throughout the past. We give you thanks for the joy of being part of the communion of saints with those who have gone before and those scattered around the globe today. Open us to your spirit to continue to be the saints you have called us to be. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Let us sing together in our opening hymn from Voices United, number 705.
Thank you.
have a seat. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, a peace the world cannot give. May the peace of Christ be with you." Thank you. We have been sharing the peace with one another using sign language, so let us practice that and then take a moment to share peace with one another. So in sign language, peace looks like this. We put our palms together, back and forth, and motion down like this. Peace, be with. Bring our fists together with our thumbs up, be with, and you. So peace, be with, you. And the response, we make two Y's with our hands and motion back and forth like this, and also with you. Peace, be with you, and also with you. Let us take a moment to share the peace of Christ with one another. That's right. I love taking the time to share peace because it gets us to be intentional about looking and seeing who is in our midst and greeting our neighbor with some intention behind it. So thank you for taking a moment to share the peace with those in our midst. Well, it's time to see if we have any kids online. We have only big kids in the sanctuary today. Stephen, do we have, well, Leslie's here. Would you like to come up front, Leslie, for a story?
We have a couple of kids there, Jen.
We do.
We have the Beck dolls, and we also have we have Michelle, Graham, Brendan.
There's Brendan. Hello, and there's Delaney. I bet you Roman is not too far off. Roman, do you want to give a wave? Okay, he's there. Good morning. So thank you for tuning in and spending a moment with me in church today. Today we are talking all about saints. Do either of you know what a saint is? What would you say if I told you that your mom and dad were saints? Would that like blow your mind? I see Murray's hand in there going, I don't know. Well, I think so. I think, so when we think about saints, we tend to think about people who have done extraordinary and elaborate things. We think of people like Jesus or, like God. Like, we start to think really big. But I tend to think that saints are really ordinary people like you and me who intentionally spread love in the world. God's love, right? So that's really all it takes to be a saint. And I think that your parents love you. Would you say that your parents love you and nurture you? Look at Delaney. Oh, I don't know. I hope so. So I think that qualifies them as saints. What do you think about that? Hi, Erica. Good morning. I bet there is a saint that you don't know you know. I can think of a saint that you know. Can you? I've got my handy dandy little book of the saints here, and I looked through it, and he's in there. And he's going to come to town. Ah, St. Nicholas. Yeah, I don't have the right tune there, but St. Nicholas is coming to town. There we go, sort of. So St. Nicholas is Santa Claus, right? And St. Nicholas, let's see if we have a picture of him in here. I wish the picture was a little bigger, but it's not. So maybe Mike and Noah will zoom in a little bit. Let's see. There we go. There is St. Nicholas. It's actually this one over here. And you know why he was a saint? He was a saint because he especially cared for children. And anyone who's cared for children must be a saint, right? So that's how St. Nicholas becomes Santa Claus, because St. Nicholas specifically took care of children, and so does Santa Claus. So sometimes there are saints all around us, and we just don't realize it. So we take a moment to realize that the people around us love us very, very much. And when they love us very, very much, they are saints of God. They're saints of God's love. So that's all about the saints today. Now, I wanted to ask you about a question about what's tomorrow? Are you really excited about tomorrow? Ooh, Brendan's got it. What's tomorrow? Yeah, exactly.
It's Halloween!
That's right, it's Halloween. It is, it's one of my favorite days of the year. What are you being for Halloween this year? What are you gonna be, Brendan?
A dinosaur, and I even got the costume right here.
A dinosaur! Amazing! And I love it. What kind of dinosaur?
Tyrannosaurus.
Is that a bronto?
It's a tyrannosaurus.
A green one. I love it. I love it. Green dinosaurs are my favorite. My favorite. What about Erica? Erica, are you going out for Halloween?
I'm dressing up as Sky. And Jamie's getting his costume, which takes a longer time to.
Right. Who's tall enough?
This is his hat. Can you guess by the hat? Probably.
A fireman.
Yep.
Awesome.
The coat.
Delaney and Roman, are you going out?
In the pants.
Yeah, we're both going out with our friends. And Roman is going to be a soccer player, and I'm going to be a magician.
Oh, wow. That is awesome. Do you want to give us a magic trick?
I don't know.
Yeah. You know the magic, I know one magic trick on Halloween, and that is here's a full bowl of candy, and now it's gone. But it ends up right in here, so I try not to buy too much. Well, when you go out for Halloween, I want you to be very safe. Yes, Mary, what are you going out for Halloween? Oh, I thought Jamie was going to be the fireman. Oh, I thought Jamie was going to be the fireman. Yeah. That's okay. That's all right. So, I forget where I was going with that, but that's all right. That's all right. I want you to be very safe when you are out trick-or-treating this year. And maybe when you come to church next time, you'll bring me a piece of candy for my belly. Okay? Okay. Let us say a prayer. Loving God, we thank you for the children in our lives, because they, most of all, teach our hearts and our minds how to become and remember what it's like to be in a sense of wonder and awe all the time, and to have that sense of vulnerability, and to always be in a place where it's okay to question. And in those ways, children remind us what it's like to be in the kingdom of heaven. And so thank you for the presence of the children in our midst. Keep them safe as they trick or treat. May they realize all the love that they have around them this week. Amen. Bye for now. Bye-bye. See you later. As we prepare our hearts to hear our scriptures, let us sing.
Thank you.
will read our scripture for us today.
Our scripture reading this morning is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 6, verses 20 to 31, from the New Revised Standard Version of the Bible. Then Jesus looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice on that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven, for that is how their ancestors treated the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you will have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is how their ancestors treated the false prophets. But I say to you who are listening, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who mistreat you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not even withhold your shirt. Give to everyone who asks of you, and if anyone takes away what is yours, do not ask for it back. Do to others as you would have them do to you. Here lies wisdom.
Thanks be to God. Let us sing. Voices United. My glasses, 896.
Thank you.
Tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday form what is known as All Hallowtide. All Hallowtide consists of All Hallows' Eve, All Saints' Day, and All Souls' Day. These 3 days are suggestive of a trinity of sorts, whereby three distinct expressions culminate into one expression of God. This Christian season gives us the opportunity to survey the life and times of saints, the saints of old and new, recalling those who have gone before us and those who are in our midst now, so that we all may be united. Saints used to become saints if they were killed or martyred for living Christian values. In many cases, saints became saints because their character exemplified a Christian ethic, and their stories of life and loss were told over and over again and passed down through the generations. It seems to me, oftentimes, saints are simply ordinary people who accomplished extraordinary things, past, present, and future. In terms of All Saints and All Souls, many of us Christians do not agree, surprise, surprise, on the definition, but there is one thing that we have never disagreed on, and that is the belief that when we celebrate, when we commune, when we pray, when we sing, and when we love, we are connected to all who have ever done so in the name of the God of love, past, present, and future. All Souls recognizes our loved ones whose physical presence is no longer among us, but whose energy resonates vibrantly because we remain connected. I wonder what the souls of saints are saying to us today. What message do they bring to us from across the veil? Often, when we think of saints, we think of martyrdom on a grand scale, but truly, simply the act of love is in itself a type of martyrdom. If our faith is in God and God is love, then when we suffer loss, there is a part of us that dies for the price of love. And so, does that not make all who love saints of God? Jesus sat on a hill one day and told a story we tell over and over again, passing it down through the ages. He told a story of people who mourned, but with hope, who failed, but raised again, who were abused, but resilient. He told of a people who were angry and poor in spirit, but yet they had peacefulness. He told the story of a people who fed until all were full. He told the story of a people lacking everything, yet were rich beyond belief. He told of a people, ordinary people, who became extraordinary because they loved. We are not only celebrating the saints gone by, we are celebrating us here and now. And we celebrate today to show the ones to come that a community built in love is still worth fighting for. In this week's scripture, we encountered the Beatitudes, this time from the Gospel of Luke, whereby Jesus describes certain conditions that are found in ones that he teaches are blessed. The Greek word used in the Beatitudes is the word makarios, which means happy. Jesus, in his Sermon on the Mount, flips what makes for a happy person. Originally, this Greek connotation of this kind of happy was used to describe a fortunate person as measured by material security and prosperity. But Jesus flips this and makes the happy person poor, persecuted, the one who weeps, and the one who is rejected. Jesus changes the definition of blessed by changing what is valued by a blessed person. The people of Jesus's day would have made the connection that Jesus is portraying himself here in the Sermon on the Mount as the new Moses. In the Old Testament, Moses goes up the mount and brings back the teaching of the Ten Commandments, or in other words, God's law. Jesus is portrayed as going up the mount and offering a new teaching that transforms the understanding of law into a new understanding of love. What is happening here in the Sermon on the Mount is that Jesus is transforming the thou shalt into the blessed are's by changing what is of value in a relationship with God. We are no longer required to keep God's law, we are required to become God's love. Jesus's first official message to the people is a message that changes God's story from one of law to one of love. Today, as we celebrate All Saints Sunday, we have the opportunity to embrace the quite often ordinary people who accomplish great things, not because they uphold some ancient law, but because they embodied the way of love, and in doing so, accomplished extraordinary things. Blessed are those who weep and mourn, who are poor and persecuted, reviled and rejected for the sake of love, for they shall see God, and in seeing God are forever happy, blessed, and added to the long lists of saints among us, for where love is, God is able to reside. Love is the dwelling place for God. St. Paul, in his letter to the Ephesians, confirms this when he says, "You are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are citizens with the saints and also members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the cornerstone. In him, the whole structure is joined together and grows into a holy temple, in whom you also are built together spiritually into a dwelling place for God." God cannot live where love is absent. When you love, you become an integral piece of the material, holding together a structure in which God dwells. When was the last time you thought of yourself as a saint? When was the last time you mourned over the loss of a loved one? When is the last time you served a purpose greater than yourself in the name of love? When is the last time you looked in the mirror and decided to love yourself rather than criticize or condemn? When is the last time you wanted to give up, but in the end, you didn't? When was the last time you pushed through your fear and did something courageous for the sake of love? The saints of history were no different than you and me today. They were people who followed the way of love at all cost, even in the face of evil. Are we not a community knit together by giving ourselves over to a common cause that's greater than ourselves? I believe we are. And in that way, I say to all of you, you are modern day saints. The reign of God is not something that happens to us. It is something that we become each and every time we choose love. And each time we choose the loving thing, we solidify and fortify our foundation of faith upon which we continually create our dwelling place for God. Lutheran pastor Nadia Boltz-Weber puts it this way, and this is it. This is the life that we get here on earth. We get to give it away. We get to give away what we receive. We get to believe in each other. We get to forgive and be forgiven. We get to love imperfectly, and we never know what effect it will have for years to come. And all of it is completely worth it. We are the architects of God's reign. When we love each other, we are citizens with the saints, we are blessed, and we are pure in heart, for in this way the Spirit of the Creator draws close, and we shall see God. Amen. From the beginning of time, humans have gathered at sacred moments, from birth to death. Death and resurrection are at the heart of our faith. For more than a millennium, since the year 1048, Christians have commemorated All Souls as an expression of the Christian belief in the communion of saints, the mystical solidarity uniting all of the body of Christ living on earth and those who have died and are now one with God. This web allows spiritual energy to flow between the living and the dead by way of prayer and good works. Let us commune with the saints gone by, our loved ones who have passed on, and symbolize their energy that continues to live amongst us by way of candle lighting. Anyone, everyone, is invited to make your way forward as you are able and light a candle for the dearly departed that you are thinking of today. And as we prepare our hearts to light our candles, let's pray. God of grace and glory, we come before you today to commend the souls of our loved ones. As we remember those who have died, we light a candle in thanksgiving to you for the gift of their life. We thank you for the giving our loved ones as companions in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console those who mourn. Grant us that we may see in death the gate of everlasting life and continue our course on earth in faith, through Jesus Christ, the life and the resurrection of all who put their trust in him. Amen. You are invited to come forth and light a candle from the Christ. Together with the communion of saints living and dead, let us now sing together from Voices United, number 710. Friends, let's pray. Extraordinary God, thank you for the things that do not end, The wind swirling around the globe, the sea rocking back and forth in its seabed, the sun rising and setting as we spin through space. Thank you for all the transient things we know, the frost on the window, the clouds and their majestic sailing beauty, the grass that flourishes for a season and withers, our own breath that once belonged to you. Give us love for the whole earth, every part of it, and the living things who inhabit it. For your love flowed through the saints of old, and it continues to flow through us today, the same one eternal love, love which we cannot contain, but which can flow through us in mysterious and wonderful ways. Thank you for the ways that you pull beauty from the wreckage of our honest mistakes by ever shining your light of grace. Help us this week to be channels of your love. Where there is injury, let us bring healing. Where there is want, help us share. Where there is injustice, solidarity. And where there is despair, hope. May we reflect the image in how we love. Reflect your image in how we love, care, and pray for the world and for one another. Bless us, your community, that we be a beacon of hope, grace, and love, and light in this world. May our open doors reflect your open arms and open hands, reaching out to those in need as a reflection of your abundant love. And let us now pause and take a moment to reflect upon the situations or speak aloud the names of individuals to whom we wish the Emmanuel community to pray for. Let us take that moment now. The Emmanuel community holds in prayer Richard Durant and the Babcock family and Melissa's co-worker. And so, we bring together all our prayers, those spoken and those in the quiet of our hearts, and I ask you to join me as we say together an alternative version of the Lord's Prayer. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God in whom we experience heaven, the hallowing of your name echoes through the universe. May the way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. May your will be done by all created beings. May your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and be realized on earth. Next slide, please. With the bread we need for today, feed us. May we be forgiven in equal measure to which we forgive, and for the hurts we absorb from one another, heal us. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From trials too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Now, as God's saints in this time and in this place, we have the opportunity to feed others physically and spiritually from the abundance we all have. We offer our whole selves to you, Creator God, as we offer our gifts for the work of your church. Help us to be mindful of all that we can do together as the body of Christ formed in love. Giver of all good things, let your grace flow through us, a generous stream, unstoppable, refreshing, abundant. Thank you, God, for the generosity that enables us to share. As we listen to our offertory this morning, all of the ways that you can continue to support the Emmanuel community and its outreach programs will be on your screens, and there is physical offering plates at the back of the sanctuary. Let us listen to our offertory, and our offerings will now be received. And let's pray. Abundant God, we dedicate our offerings and ourselves to the shaping of community, the community you intend in the Spirit of Christ, for we bring you what is already yours, Creator God. Accept these gifts for the work of your church, that they may transform and become an action of love for all. Accept these gifts from our hands, which we cast upon the waters of your love, a generous, ever-flowing stream. Amen. Let us join us together and sing our closing hymn, Voices United 479.
Thank you.
Saints of God, upon the foundation all souls have laid, go from here as a dwelling place for God, hopeful in the knowing that you trod a saintly path, doing unto others as you would have them do to you. Because God blesses you, God keeps you, God's face is forever shining upon you. And it is for this reason that the peace of Christ is with us all. Amen.